for me, I like joining the dots between what the scientists are telling us, what the community's telling us, and looking at what water's available and trying to put the pieces of the puzzle together to get the best outcomes for any given year. Lakes and Coorong, it's the only estuary in the Murray-Darling Basin, and it's pretty special because it's got a wide range of different habitats. So from the freshwater in Lakes Alexandrina and Albert to the special meeting of the waters is a registered Aboriginal heritage site. So that's the area downstream of the barrages around the Murray Mouth where the fresh and salt water come together. And then the Coorong goes from marine salinities right down to hypermarine salinities at the very end of the South Lagoons. That mixture of all those different habitats means that we have a huge variety of plants and animals that are endemic to the area. In October last year, we had our inaugural joint meeting of our science and community reference groups. One of our community members is a commercial fisherman and he said, "Hey guys, something kind of interesting is happening down below the barrages. I've been seeing adult black bream and they're looking like they're running ripe. Haven't seen that for many years." Within the Coorong, our black bream population's been in pretty steady decline since the mid-1980s. Black bream are quite finicky. They're kind of like the Goldilocks of the fish world. We had our scientists going out weekly just to measure the salinity conditions in the Coorong, just to make sure that we were releasing water in the right way. And over summer, it looked like we were creating really good conditions. So as the year progressed, we went out, we did our fish monitoring. We did monitoring in January, we did monitoring in March. We hadn't found any new recruits of black bream. So we were getting a little bit despondent. We put all this time and effort and money into this project and we didn't really have anything to show for it. The scientists were like, "Oh, you know, it's not too bad. We've learnt how to deliver the water and we'll take this learning for future years." And I guess there just wasn't enough of the adults around to do anything. So we were like, okay. And then we had one final monitoring round in April. We got the results back and we had over 100 of these little guys in the Coorong. So. So we're really excited that we've been able to have that positive impact on the black bream population and pretty proud that we were able to use environmental water in a way that allowed us to get this great outcome. I'd like to see the relationships that we've got with our scientists and with our community members and with the Narrangeri to continue and to strengthen. I think over the past few years, some of the best outcomes we've achieved has been when all of those groups are working together and we can get the best outcomes when that's happening.